Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I'm doing a brief review for the final exam for Math 90, which is basic math. Brief because I'm going to talk about things rather quickly, and if you need more review, you should go back and watch the original videos that came with each topic. When you subtract something, you can't subtract unless you borrow in this particular problem. We're going to borrow from the 3 and make that 2. And what we borrowed was 100. So we're going to make this 9 and make this 10. 10 minus 5 is 5, and 9 minus 9 is 0. And 2 minus 8, well, now I can't do that, so I'm going to borrow from the 1 here. And this one I'm only adding it onto here. That's going to make that 12, which is 4, and then 1,405. How do you check something like that? Go back and add these two numbers up. You should get the minuend that you started with. 5 and 5 is 0. Carry the 1. 9 and 1 is 0. Carry the 1. 8 and 4 is 12. Plus 1 is 3. Carry the 1 is 2. And we get 2,300 as our check. So the solution or the difference here is this. Notice I wrote this as 90 and then 10. That equals the 100 that we borrowed originally. When you are rounding to any number, you're looking at the number to the right of where you're headed. So to round this to the tens, I look at the tens place and I look one to the right. If that number is 5 or greater, I round up. And if it's less than 5, I would stay the same. In this case, the 8 is more than 5, so I would have 47,380. When you're rounding with whole numbers, you put zeros on the end. Okay, now if you're rounding in decimals to the hundredths is right here. That is two places over. This was the ones and the tens, but this starts at tens and then hundredths. And so if you're asked to round to the hundredths, that's two decimal places. So you want to make sure that your answer has two decimal places in it when you're finished. So if this is a 9, I look one to the right, that's an 8, so I go up. But 69 would round up to 70, and even though I could just put 35.7, I need to put the 70 because I need to show that to the hundredths place. Otherwise, I would drop that 0. I want to make sure, though, I go out two places. And then rounding to the nearest cent, well, be careful because a cent is a hundredth. A century is 100, right? Hundredths is right here. So I'm rounding to the hundredths in this case as well. Looking one to the right, that 7 is going to make that go up, and I'm going to get 2.35. If I had something like $3.192, and I wanted to round that to the nearest cent, because the 2 is less than 5, I'm going to keep that the same. That would round to $3.19. So if it's 5 or more, go up. If it's less than 5, you stay the same. You don't drop down, but you stay the same. And the last thing on this really brief little video is order of operations. Remember the order of operations, you do what's inside parentheses first. Might be outside the box there, outside the parentheses. And then you do the exponents. And then the next step is multiply and divide. I'm going to say divide and multiply because everybody always says multiply and divide, but it's whichever one comes first from left to right. And then you add and subtract, or subtract and add, whichever comes first from left to right. Inside these parentheses, then, we're going to do, we have addition and we have an exponent. Exponent's going to come first. 3 to the second power just is 3 times 3, right? So that means 9. So I have 3 plus 9. And the rest of this I'm going to go ahead and just bring down. I'm going to work inside the parentheses. 3 plus 9 is 12. And then divided by 2, and then times 2 to the third. Now here's where people usually will make a mistake and say, well, we're going to do this multiplication, but in fact you're going to do the division, and then because it came first, you're going to do 12 divided by 2, which is 6, and then you're going to multiply it by the exponent. Oh, should have done that exponent first, right? But that's like the last thing that's going to happen. 2 to the third power is 8. I could have done that though up here and gotten 8 right here, But I wouldn't multiply the 2 and the 8 until after that division happened. So I kind of forgot about that exponent, but it's not going to change it because we weren't going to do anything with that until the very end, and 6 times 8 is 48. Over here, a square root is like an exponent in this order of operations thing. So the square root of 25 is 5. Maybe you don't remember what a square root of 25 is or whatever. Any calculator that you have will do that for you. Let me clear all that out. Okay. You want to use the square root button, which is typically a second button. That is, it's not actually on a button, it's above it. You can tell maybe in this one that you have a blue. And so what I'm going to do is hit second function, which takes me to those blue buttons that are above the actual keys. And then I want to put in the 25 and hit enter to get the 5. So maybe you know it in your head, maybe you need to put it in a calculator. And then 3 squared is 9. So looking at the top, I'm going to end up with 9 plus 5 is 14. Just working the top all the way. But notice I left the denominator in there. I hate to forget about that, so I want to keep leaving space for it. 15 minus 13 is 2. And down here, I have 2 plus 2, which is 4. Plus 14. I think that was supposed to be something else, but whatever. I made a mistake when I wrote the problem. So I have 14 on top, and I have 4 plus 14, or 18, on the bottom. And I'd always want to reduce that to lowest terms. If I divide both the top and the bottom by 2, I get 7 over 9. All right, that's order of operations with whole numbers. Also, rounding, and just a brief thing on subtraction. You could have multiplication or division or addition on this test. Remember, when we talk about a subtraction problem, it's a difference. If they ask you to find the sum, that is addition. If they ask you to find the product, that's multiplication. And if they ask you to find the quotient, that's division. All right. So have a great day. We'll see you for the next.